किड्स, शुभम मंगलम एट लिटिल स्कॉलर हाई स्कूल. आई एम संगीता सिंह, टेकिंग 8th स्टैंडर्ड, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश. एंड द टॉपिक टू बी डिस्कस टुडे इज यूनिट 1, स्टडी मटेरियल. किड्स, यू ऑल नो दैट इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द पैसेजेस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड द क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स बेस्ड ऑन द टेक्स्ट बुक एंड मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द पैसेजेस. नाउ लेट अस प्रोसीड टू द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन बी, दैट इज वोकैबुलरी एंड ग्रामर. सो वॉट इज वोकैबुलरी? Can you define what is vocabulary? So vocabulary is a set of words or a body of words in a particular language or in any language. So whether you take English, Hindi or Telugu, every language has its own words, which is called a vocabulary. Vocabulary is also called as a word stock. So every person has a vocabulary, that is the words understood and used by a person. So it differs from person to person. A small child can have his own vocabulary. He might be knowing or understanding only a few words. So as a young man might be having more set of words, he might be understood by more words as well as under new words, isn't it? So similarly, as the age increases, a person's vocabulary also increases. So this, how is it important for us, isn't it? So vocabulary improves all areas of communication like listening skills, speaking skills, reading skills and writing skills. So a person needs to have good vocabulary, and vocabulary can be increased, vocabulary of a person can be increased daily by adding new words, isn't it? By learning new words. Now let us see how to do this section B, vocabulary and grammar. Now I want all of you to turn to page number 34 of your study material. Now these are the question numbers 17 to 21 are covered in this section B. Question numbers 17 to 21, and we have your passages. Let's do passage 1. Read the following passage focusing on the parts underlined and answer the questions given at the end as directed. So I am reading the passage now. You have to focus, you have to concentrate on the parts which are underlined here, and you have to answer the questions given at the end as directed, means as per the instructions. Now each question carries 1 mark. So passage 1 says, no, it is quite near. So the word near is underlined. It is question number 17. I don't know how I can bring back her memory, Gopi's sister said to him exasperatedly. The word exasperatedly is underlined. It is question number 18. Gopi placed his briefcase on the thina. He opened it and pulled for the contents. So the phrase pulled for is underlined here. Is question number 19. Clothes, files, a shaving set. You do know is underlined here. It's question number 20. My son Gopi, Amma asked him. He is in Delhi, a government officer. He has Kesari Yogam. He drawn. The word drawn is underlined. It's question number 21. A salary of 2,500 rupees. Now we have to follow the instructions which are given here and write the answers according to the directions or the instructions which are given here. Question number 17 says, here the word near is underlined. So we have to write the antonym of the underlined word. Now what is antonym? Antonym is a word which is opposite in meaning, or simply you can say it is an opposite word. So here the antonym of near is far. So the answer is far. Question number 17, answer is far. Now question number 18, Gopi's sister said to him exasperatedly. So what does the word exasperatedly mean? It means very annoyed, very angry or irritated. You can say exasperatedly. The meaning of exasperatedly is very annoyed. Question number 19. Clothes, files, a shaving set. You do know. So the words you do know, you have to replace the underlined phrasal verb, isn't it? Yeah, sorry. He pulled it out and pulled for the contents. 19th one is pulled for. Pulled for is called as a phrasal verb. Pulled is verb, for is preposition. Pulled for means to pull something out, to search something. So here the phrasal verb pulled for should be replaced with the correct phrasal verb. Okay, the phrasal verb pulled for should be replaced with the correct phrasal verb which can suit this sentence. So here it should be pulled out. So pulled for will be replaced with pulled out. Pulled out is pulling out the pulling out the briefcase, isn't it? So he pulled out, he opened up and pulled out. He pulled out the briefcase and he found all these things. Now you do know question number 20, the word order is not improper, isn't it? The word order is not properly placed here. So you need to put the words in the proper order. So instead of you do know, it should be do you know my son. So replace you do know with do you know. Question number 21. Yes, he drawn a salary of 2500 rupees. He has Kesar Yogam. So has represents present tense and he drawn. Drawn is the third form of the verb which is present participle, isn't it? So here the word drawn, write the correct form of the verb is saying. Question number 21 says write the correct form of the verb. So drawn is the V3 form, like draw, drew, drawn. Draw is present tense, drew is past tense, drawn is past participle. So here the verb form should be present tense draws. The drawn will be replaced with draws. Now let us see second passage. Again we have question numbers 17 to 21. 17th one. I got a promotion last year. After that I am always on my toes. And after that I am always on my toes is underlined here. It's a question number 17. And there are toes quiet often. The word quiet is underlined. And question number 18 it is. I don't get any time to write letters. Why don't you ask Vimla to write? Or doesn't she get any time to? What are you mumbling over there? The word mumbling is underlined. It is question number 19. Amma said loudly, I heard somebody come in a car. The word come is underlined. It's question number 20. Who is it? I told you it's Gopi. But Gopi is at Delhi. So the word at is underlined. It's question number 21. Isn't he? Yes, Amma, it's me. I have come from Delhi. Now look at the question number 17. After that, I am always on my toes. So pick out the idiom which means busy from the underlined sentence. So what is idiom? Idiom is a group of words which has its own meaning, which is which does not give the exact meaning of the words. It has its own meaning. So pick out the idiom which means busy from the underlined sentence. So the phrase on toes. On toes represents it is busy. On toes. Busy means on toes. Now question number 18. And there are toes quiet often. Q-U-I-E-T quiet means to be silent, calm. So we are talking about the frequency of the toes. So here it should be quite often, means very often. It is Q-U-I-T-E quiet. Q-U-I-E-T quiet should be replaced with Q-U-I-T-E quiet. Now next question number 19 is what are you mumbling over there? So what is the meaning of the underlined word mumbling? So mumbling here means speaking unclearly and quietly. The meaning of mumbling is speaking unclearly and quietly. So 19th answer is speaking unclearly and quietly. Question number 20. Amma said loudly, I heard somebody come in a car. So use the correct form of the verb. Question number 20 says use the correct form of the verb. It should be I heard somebody coming in a car. The word come is in present tense. We should use the ing form of it, that is present participle, coming in a car. So question number 20, come will be replaced with coming. क्वेश्चन नंबर 21. बट गोपी इज एट दिल्ली इजंट ही. सो द वर्ड एट, यूज द करेक्ट प्रपोजिशन इन द प्लेस ऑफ द अंडरलाइंड वन. द क्वेश्चन इज यूज द करेक्ट प्रपोजिशन इन द प्लेस ऑफ अंडरलाइंड वन. सो हियर एट इज द प्रपोजिशन विच इज अंडरलाइंड इन द पैसेज. We need to use the correct preposition. So the preposition at is used for smaller places, whereas in the preposition in is used for big or larger places. So here Delhi is considered to be a big place. So we cannot use at Delhi. It should be, the preposition at should be replaced with in. So write in Delhi. Now let us see passage number 3. Again we have question number 17 to 21. 17th one. Let us see the third passage. When he arrived unexpectedly at his home in the countryside. The word countryside is underlined. It is question number 17. In his office car and got down at the gate, his mother, who was lying in an armchair on the veranda, made a futile, the word futile is underlined. It is question number 18. Attempt to get off. The word get off, it is a phrasal verb. Get off is underlined. It is question number 19. Kamala, there is somebody at the gate, she said. Somebody was in a car. Kamala, her eldest daughter, a widow, who was sitting huddled up on the thinner on the veranda, her head and ears covered with a thin bath towel, got up reluctantly. The word reluctantly is underlined. It is question number 21. Walked slowly to the gate and screwing up her eyes, peered into the darkness. Now let us see the directions what are given here. Question number 17. The word countryside means it is village. So let's see question number 17. The answer is the word countryside means it is village. Now question number 18. Futile. The word futile is underlined. Futile attempt. So write the synonym of the underlined word futile. So what is synonym? Synonym is a word which has similar meaning or almost the same meaning. So the synonym of futile is unsuccessful. Synonym of futile is unsuccessful. Question number 19. Get off is underlined. So get is called as a verb and off is a preposition. So a combination of a verb and a preposition is called as a phrasal verb and it has its own meaning. So the word, you have to use the correct phrasal verb in place of get off. So it should be, he made a futile attempt to get up. Get off should be replaced with get up. So meaning of get off is to go away from that place. Meaning of get up is to get up from a particular place. So here it should be get up. Question number 20. Now somebody was in a car. So first she says, Kamala, there is somebody at the gate. So there is somebody at the gate means the word is, the verb is represents, it is present tense. And in the next sentence she says, somebody was in a car. The verb was represents past tense. So when the first sentence is in the present tense, the next sentence also should be changed to the present tense. The verb was, which is in past tense, should be replaced with the verb in present tense is. So question number 20, was should be replaced with is. Now question number 21, reluctantly, she got up reluctantly. So here what is the question to be done? Write the opposite of the underlined word. What is the opposite of the word? Reluctantly. So the meaning of reluctantly is not willingly, not willing to do something. Reluctant means not willing to do something. So here we are asked to write the opposite of unwillingly is willingly. Opposite of unwillingly is willingly. Now let us proceed to passage 4. How happy we were in our school. We used sit in the same row. That is question number 17. We used sit in the same row is underlined. Did all the work together and took part in the events. I remember how Padmanabhaiya sir, our class teacher, appreciated us. Why? The word why is underlined. It is question number 18. We got the first prize in district science fair. I remember. The word remember is underlined. Question number 19. How we went on a picnic to Koil Sagar. There we went boating. Our tour to Sri Sailam was memorably. The word memorably is underlined. It is question number 20. Still I remember the green hills full of trees that almost touch the sky. I remember the roaring of the Krishna River of is underlined. It's question number 21, the dam. The question number 17, rewrite the underlined expression after correcting it. So what is the expression here given? We used to sit in the same row. So we have to rewrite the expression. There is a mistake in this expression. So a preposition is missing here. So we have to correct the underlined expression and rewrite it. So it should be, we used to sit in the same row. So whenever you want to talk about the past habits, we use the expression used to. We use the words used to tell about any past action or a past habit. So it should be, we used to sit in the same row should be corrected and written as, we used to sit in the same row. So let's see. Question number 17. We used to sit in the same row. Question number 18. Yes. Padmanabhaya sir, our class teacher appreciated us why we got the first prize in our district. So when did he appreciate? When you got the first prize. So the word why should be replaced. The question word why should be replaced with the question word when. It is also called, it's a conjunction here. So I remember how Padmanabhaya sir, our class teacher appreciated us. So this is one sentence. We got the first prize in the district science fair is the second sentence. So these two sentences are joined with the conjunction why here, but it is not the suitable conjunction. We have to write the suitable conjunction in place of why, and that should be when. So I remember how Padmanabhaya sir, our class teacher appreciated us when we got the first prize in district science fair. So the word why will be replaced with when. Question number 19. I remember how we went on a picnic to Koil Sagar. So question number 19 says, what is the antonym of the underlined word? Remember is underlined here in the question number 19. We have to write the antonym. Now what is antonym? A word which is opposite in meaning is called antonym. So the opposite of remember is forget. Question number 20. There we went boating. Our tour to Sri Sailam was memorably. So you are describing the tour to Sri Sailam. How was it? It should be memorable. The word memorably is adverb. But whenever you are describing a noun, tour is noun here. So whenever you are describing a noun, the adjective is used. The describing words are called adjectives. So memorable is the adjective which should be used here. So question number 20, the word memorably will be replaced with memorable. Now question number 21. Still I remember the green hills full of trees that almost touch the sky. I remember the roaring of the Krishna River of the dam. The word of is underlined here. So use the of is a preposition. We have to use the correct preposition in the place of the underlined word. So here the right preposition is Krishna River at the dam. Okay, roaring of the Krishna River at the dam, we should say. So the preposition of is replaced with the preposition at. Now let us see passage 5. Again we have question numbers 17 to 21. Let's see 17th one. Kamala, her eldest daughter, a widow, who was sitting huddled up on the thinna on the veranda, her head and ears covered with a thin bath towel, got up reluctantly, walked slow. So slow is underlined here, it is question number 17, to the gate, and screwing up her eyes peered into the darkness. So here screwing up her eyes peered into the darkness is underlined, it is question number 18. She saw a bald, fat, middle-aged man walking in through the gate. So From a bald, fat, middle-aged man walking into the gate is question number 19. Oh, Gopi, she said in her grating voice. The word grating is underlined here. It is number 20. Why this sudden unexpected visit? Kamala, who is it? Her mother asked loudly. The word loudly is underlined. It is number 21 from the veranda. Now, according to the directions, question number 17 says, write the right form of the word. So, how she walked, she got up reluctantly. So, the word reluctantly tells us how she got up. The way how she is doing the action. Reluctantly is adverb. Walked. Walked is verb. How she walked, it should be not slow, slowly. So, the word slow will be replaced with slowly. It is an adverb. Walked slowly. Slowly is adverb. Next. Screwing up her eyes, peered into the darkness. Question number 18 says, pick out the phrase which means narrowing. From the underlined sentence, we have to pick up the phrase. Phrase is a group of words which doesn't have complete meaning. So we have to pick up the phrase which means narrowing. So here, screwing up her eyes, peered into the darkness means she narrowed her eyes to look into the darkness. So that she can see clearly. So here the word screwing up means narrowing. Screwing up means narrowing. Question number 19. She saw a bald, fat, middle-aged man walking in through the gate. So question number 19 says, pick out the noun phrase from the underlined part. So what is a noun phrase? So here the man is the noun here, but what are the words which are used to describe the man? A bald, fat, middle-aged. All these are the adjectives which are used to describe the man, and it is called as a noun phrase here because it is describing a man. So here, pick out the noun phrase from the underlined part. So it is a bald, fat, middle-aged man. Middle-aged man. This is the noun phrase. Now, question number 20. She said in her grating voice. The word grating is underlined. And what is the meaning of the word grating? Here it is unpleasant voice. Grating. The meaning of the word grating is unpleasant. Grating voice is unpleasant voice. Now, question number 21. Her mother asked loudly from the veranda. So the word loudly is underlined. We are asked to write the opposite of the word loudly, which is quietly. Opposite of loudly is quietly. Q-U-I-E-T-L-Y, quietly. Now let us see the passage number 6. Again we have question numbers 17 to 21. Now, what did Gopi marry? So, the word what is underlined here? This question 17. Amma said, suddenly. The word suddenly is underlined. It is number 18, lowering her voice. I mean, what's his wife's name? Don't say you have forgotten her name too. Don't you remember, Vimla? District collector Nambiar, eldest daughter. So, district collector Nambiar, eldest daughter is underlined. It is number 19. Gopi's sister said, oh, I forgot the name. Was there a letter with Gopi today? The word with is underlined here. It is number 20. There was. He wrote every day. The word wrote is underlined here. It is number 21. I am terribly upset if I don't get a letter from him every day. Now, question number 17. The instructions are, replace the WH word with the correct one. Can we say, what did Gopi marry? So, we are talking about a person whom Gopi married. So, who did Gopi marry? So, the question word, WH word, what, will be replaced with another WH word which is called who. Who did Gopi marry? Amma said, suddenly. The word suddenly is underlined. We have to write the opposite of the word suddenly. It is gradually. Opposite of suddenly is gradually. क्वेश्चन नंबर 19. यस, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर नंबियर एल्डेस्ट डॉटर, डोंट यू रिमेंबर विमला? हु इज विमला? डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर नंबियर एल्डेस्ट डॉटर. सो व्हाट इज दैट वी हैव टू डू? करेक्ट द नाउन फ्रेज एंड रीराइट इट. सो वी आर, वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ पर्सन, इट्स अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर नंबियर्स एल्डेस्ट डॉटर, सो इट शुड बी रिप्लेस विथ एल्डेस्ट डॉटर ऑफ नंबियर. सो वी से नंबियर्स एल्डेस्ट डॉटर, नंबियर अपोस्ट्रोफी यस. सो राइट द करेक्ट नाउन फ्रेज इज डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर नंबियर्स, नंबियर अपोस्ट्रोफी नंबियर्स एल्डेस्ट डॉटर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. यस, वॉज देर ए लेटर विथ गोपी टूडे? सो रिप्लेस द अंडरलाइंड प्रपोजिशन विद द करेक्ट वन. द वर्ड विथ इज अंडरलाइंड हियर, इट इज अ प्रपोजिशन, इट शुड बी रिप्लेस्ड विद द करेक्ट प्रपोजिशन. वॉज देर ए लेटर विथ गोपी, इट शुडंट बी विथ गोपी, वॉज देर ए लेटर from Gopi, that is the right preposition which can be used in place of with. So was there a letter from Gopi, the preposition with will be replaced with the preposition from. Now question number 21. He wrote every day. The word every day means it is present tense, isn't it? But you cannot use the word wrote. Wrote represents past tense. So here the wrote should be replaced with the correct form of the word writes. Every day is something which is done regularly, so the right form of the word wrote should be writes here. Okay students, I hope all of you understood the passages what we have done in the section B, vocabulary and the grammar part. And I hope and now I want all of you to note down today's Sakshi classwork. I've explained study material unit 1, page number 34 to 37, and homework, complete study material page number 34 to 37, and also revise the same thing, whatever the vocabulary we have done. You have learned some new words and along with their meanings, antonyms, synonyms, etc. in the passages. So I want all of you to learn and revise all these things.